How are you all? Okay, children, I had given you a worksheet on Thursday which was related to chapter number 3, playing with numbers. So today I'll be giving you the solutions of the given worksheet, and you have to cross check your answers and match that whether you have done all the questions correctly or not. So let's start with the solution of worksheets. Let's start with question number 1. Question number 1 is, write down all the factors of 24, 37 and 34. So first of all, we have to find out the factors of 24. So 24 divided by 1 is 24. 24 divided by 2 is 12. 24 divided by 3 is 8. 24 divided by 4 is 6. 24 divided by 5 is, there is a question mark, because when you will divide 24 by 5, the remainder will not be 0. Now 24 divided by 6 is 4. Now this 4 and 6, these are interchanged. Now we can stop doing this method here itself. So the factors of 24 will be this 1, because it is completely divisible by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is not there because there is a question mark, then 6. After that we have to start writing from here. 4, 6 we have already written. Now we will write this 8, then 12, and then 24. So these are the factors of 24. Now let's move to B part. 37 is divisible by 1, which is equal to 37. Children, 37 is a prime number or composite number? Yes, 37 is a prime number. So if it is a prime number, so there are only two factors of 37. That is 1 and 37. Clear? Now let's move to 34. 34 divided by 1 is 34. And 34 divided by 2 is 17. After that, it is not divisible by any number. It will be divisible by 17. That is equal to 2. So the factors of 34 will be 1, 2, 17 and 34. Clear? So that is how we have to solve this question, where we have to find out all the factors of the given numbers. Now let's move to the next question. Question is, write down the multiples of 8 less than 50. Now here we have given a fixed number, that is we cannot write the multiples of 8 which is greater than 50. So we have to write down the multiples of 8 up to 50. So here we have to write down the table of 8. 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 16, 8 threes are 24, yes, 8 fours are 32, 8 fives are 40, 8 sixes are 48, 8 sevens are 56, but 56 is greater than 50, so we cannot write 56 here. So the multiples of 8 less than 50 will be these 8, 16, 24, 30, 32, 40 and 48. Children, in my last lecture on Thursday, on Wednesday, I had done with exercise 3.1. There in question number 2, I had written, write down the multiples of the given number. But in your book, it is given, write down the first 5 multiples of the given number. So, it is not an issue. that I have written just to explain you that if you have to write down the multiples of any number, then you will write up to infinity. But if in your book it is given write down the first five multiples, then you will just write the first five multiples. Okay, so now let's come to the next question. Now we have to write down the multiples of the given number. Third question is write down the multiples of the given number. So in this question we can write the multiples up to infinity. So we don't need to write the multiples till any fixed number. So if suppose I am writing the multiples of 17, then I will be writing 17 ones are 17, 17 twos are 34, 17 threes are 51, 17 fours are 68, 17 fives are 85, 17 sixes are 102, and up to so on. Clear? Now if I talk about 15, 15 ones are 15, 15 twos are 30, 15 threes are 45, 15 fours are 60, 15 fives are 75, 15 sixes are 90. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have written till 6 multiples of 15, and then we can write down these multiples will be up to infinity. Now if we talk about 13, 13 ones are 13, 13 twos are 26, 13 threes are 39, 13 fours are 52, 13 fives are 65, 13 sixes are 78, and up to so on. So that is how we can write down the multiples of the given number, where we have not given any fixed value that we have to write till this number, we have to write down less than this number. So this was the solution of question number 3. Now let's come to question number 4. Question number 4 is write down the prime numbers between 20 and 30. So children, how we can find out the prime numbers here? First of all, we need to close all the even numbers. 20 is an even number. 22 is an even number. 24 is an even number. 26 is an even number. And then 28 is an even number. And 30 is an even number. Now we are left with 21. After putting close on the even number, now we have to check that among these numbers, what are the multiples of 3. Now we have to find out the multiples of 3. 21. 21 is a multiple of 3. 3 sevens are 21. So that cannot be a prime number. So we will cross this also. 23. It is not a multiple of 3. Then 25 is not a multiple of 3. Then 27. 27 is a multiple of 3. 3 nines are 27. After that 25. 25 is a multiple of 5. Clear? Now we are left with 23 and 29. So these are the prime numbers between 20 and 30. What we have done? Firstly, we have put close on even number. Then we have put close on the multiple of 3. Then we have put close on the multiple of 5. Clear? So after that, the numbers which will be left, that will be the prime numbers. Fine. So 23 and 29 are the prime numbers between 20 and 30. Now let's move to the next question. Question number 5 is write down composite numbers between 40 and 60. Now we have to write down the composite numbers. What are composite numbers? composite numbers means which are not prime, or we can say composite numbers have more than two factors. So firstly, we have to find out the even numbers. All even numbers are composite number 40, then 42, then 44, 46, 48, 50, 52, 54, 56, 58, and then 60. So these are composite numbers. So we can cross these numbers that we have already taken. 48, 50, 52, 54, 56, 58, and then 60. Now we have to find out the multiples of 3. Here the multiples of 3 are 45. So after 44 we can write 45. 15 threes are 45. Then the multiple of 3 are 51. Here we can write 51. 17 threes are 51. Then the multiple of 3 is 57. 19 threes are 57. After that, we have to find out the multiples of 4. Multiples of 2 and 4 we have already taken. Now we will see the multiples of 5. Okay, multiple of 5 is 55. So we can write 55 here. Then the multiple of 7. Multiple of 7 is 49. 49 is the multiple of 7. 7 sevens are 49. After that, 41, it is a prime number. 43, it's a prime number. 47, it's a prime number. 53 is a prime number. Then 59 is a prime number. So it means we have written all the composite numbers here between 40 and 60. So I'm going to write it again. 40, 42, 44, 45, 46, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, and then 60. So these are the composite numbers between 40 and 60. Clear? So that is how we can find out the composite numbers. Now let's move to the next question. Now the next question is, dash is an even prime number. So children, in the list of prime numbers, which is an even prime number? Can you tell me? Can anybody tell me? Yes, the very first prime number is 2. After that, all other prime numbers are not even numbers. All other prime numbers are odd numbers. Okay, so which is an even prime number? An even prime number is 2. It is only the even prime number in the list of prime numbers. And if we talk about 7th question, 34 is a composite number. So we can firstly check the factors of 34. That we have already done in question number 1, factors of 34. 34 divided by 1 is 34. 34 divided by 2 is 17. After that, 34 is divisible by 17, which is equal to 2. So the factors of 34 are 1, 2, 17, and 34. So is it a composite number or prime number? It is a composite number. Why? Because it has more than 2 factors. So 34 is a composite number. This statement is true. positive? Yes, it is a composite number. Clear? So now let's move to the next question. Now the next question is, the sum of an odd number and an even number is even. This statement is true or false? So let us take an odd number and an even number. Suppose I am taking 2 and 3. 2 plus 3 is 5. And if I am taking 4 and 5, 4 plus 5 is 9. Okay. I am taking one more example, that is 6 and 7. 6 plus 7 is 13. So this 5, 9 and 13, these all are odd numbers. So the sum of an odd number and an even number cannot be an even number. That will be an odd number. So this statement is false. Clear? Here I have taken an even number and here I have taken one odd number. And sum of these two numbers is again an odd number. Clear? Now let's come to ninth question. Prime numbers have only dash factors. How many factors are there for prime numbers? Prime numbers have only two factors, 1 and the number itself. And the 10th question is, composite numbers have more than dash factors. How many factors are there of composite number? Composite numbers have more than two factors. So in both these blanks, two will come. Okay, prime numbers have only two factors and composite numbers have more than two factors. Clear? So these were the solutions of the question given in the worksheet. So children, now the solutions are with you and you have to cross check your answers. And by mistake, if you have done any question wrong, then you can make the question correct. Okay? And complete your work, complete your notebooks and all the worksheets which I am giving you, you have to do in your practice notebook or in any rough notebook. Clear? Whenever the school will reopen, I am going to check all the worksheets which you have done in your practice notebook or rough notebook. So that's all for today, children. Thank you so much. God bless you.